Would you like to learn about Anycast DNS? If so, this video is for you. Hi, my name is Michael Gibbs, and I'm the founder and CEO of GoCloud Careers. And I've been a network architect, a cloud architect, and an enterprise architect for about 25 years. And one of the things that students often have a hard time understanding is something called Anycast as it pertains to DNS. And Anycast is going to be one of those critical cloud architect fundamentals, cloud engineer fundamentals, network engineer fundamentals, and network architect fundamentals. And by the time we're done with this video, it's going to be very simple for you to understand. So what is Anycast DNS? If you know about DNS, you know that DNS, for the most part, maps a name to an IP address. So instead of remembering the IP address for a certain website or for a certain system, you can remember a user-friendly name such as cisco.com or amazon.com or gocloudcareers.com. And by not having to remember that address, we get a few things. One is you don't have to know the IP addresses because DNS acts like a phone directory, but also we can do some things with DNS to enhance the performance and availability of our systems. And one of those is Anycast DNS. So traditionally in IP networking, everything is going to need to have its own unique IP address. And that's a requirement of normal networking. In Anycast, we're actually going to have more than one server with the same IP address. And what's going to happen is all these servers are going to be synchronized and their data is going to be synchronized. And we're going to reach out to the one that's closest to us. And if that's not available, we'll go and reach out to the other one. And by doing so, we can improve the performance going to the closest DNS server, as well as the availability of the system in case you can't reach the next closest DNS server. So let's evaluate this in action. In this particular example, we have a cat, my cat Cindy. Isn't she cute? But she wants to go to this cat treats website because she wants to buy cat treats. But of course, Cindy can't remember the IP address of the cat treats website. But that's okay, she goes to her DNS server. So we have Cindy here in the left-hand corner and she's behind her PC. And what she does is she goes to a browser and types www.thecattreatswebsite. And I didn't use a .com because I didn't want to take somebody else's domain. So her PC goes to the closest DNS server. Now I used 8.8.8.8. They're actually Google's DNS servers. And Google's DNS servers are Anycast, and the same way if you used Azure Front Door and cloud computing, that would be Anycast. And AWS Route 53 is also Anycast for the availability reasons we're going to describe. So Cindy would go to the DNS server, she would get the IP address for the cat treats website she's looking for, and then her packet would leave her system through her default gateway, get routed out her internet service provider to all the other internet service providers that are necessary. The cat treats website would respond to Cindy, and she would get her web page back, and then she would order all the cat treats she wants because she stole my credit card. Now that's great, right? And this is how this works. So what happens if this server were to disappear? It were just to go anywhere and it's now dead. So what ultimately happened is Cindy's PC has already been coded to look for the DNS server 8.8.8.8. So her PC would go to the internet, it would cross the internet, and it would hit this DNS server at 8.8.8.8 that's located in another part of the world. That would then provide Cindy the IP address of her favorite cat treats website. Packet would be forwarded to the cat treats website, and then ultimately the cat treats website would answer. The packets would get sent back through the internet back to Cindy, and she could order her favorite cat treats. So why is this so special? Well, it does a few things. It enhances the performance and the latency of your system, and here's the reason why. Let's say Cindy is here sitting in South Florida. Most likely, based upon the internet routing and the way it's going to work, is Cindy will hit a DNS server that's closer to Florida, which is going to minimize the latency time from the time Cindy does her DNS request to the time the DNS server responds and gives Cindy the IP address, enhancing her experience. But if that DNS server is down, it's not a problem because we've got that backup server, that Anycast server, which might actually be in San Francisco instead of, say, closer to Florida. But it doesn't matter because Cindy can still reach the Cat Treats website. Now, there's other uses for Anycast. We use Anycast in BGP. We use Anycast in IP multicast too. But in this particular case, we're talking to DNS servers. So the next time you're thinking about designing a high availability solution and you're using DNS, you want to be using Anycast, and that is the reason why, especially if you're managing your own DNS servers in, say, a traditional data center or a private cloud environment. So now you know what is Anycast DNS, how Anycast DNS improves performance, and how Anycast DNS improves the availability of your systems. If you'd like to learn how to get your first cloud architect job, your first AI architect job, your first enterprise architect job, please join us in one of our many free webinars where we'll go over the role, we'll talk about what we do, we'll talk about the necessary skills for these careers, and of course you can ask us lots of questions because they're live and free on Zoom. The description for any of these webinars and many other free tools for your career are in the description of this video, so join us. If you'd like this video, please give it a like and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell to be notified of new videos to assist you in your cloud computing career. This is Mike Gibbs signing off for now, and I look forward to seeing you soon.